Having been up most of the night, Lulu is in need of a little rest and recuperation. Wu Gong, however, still has a healthy appetite. But his lackluster performance the previous day has serious implications. Half of the centre's female pandas' estrogen levels are now peaking. They need to be mated soon, or there won't be enough pandas next year. They cannot rely solely on Lulu, despite his successful track record, because they must introduce more males to the breeding group and widen the gene pool.
We have to consider the diversity. 尽量让它不让一个熊猫表达的太多，它也一个替代作用，就是逐步的淘汰的。从理论上讲是很少的，所以我们要尽量考虑这个遗传多样性。但是卢卢也不能繁殖太多。Ling
Ling, the third male on the team, is introduced to Cao Cao. But things don't quite work out. He appears no more adept at mating than Wu Gong. Reinforcements are required. They come in the shape of Chung Chung, whose name means strong. He's actually a 21-year-old male panda in the process of losing his teeth and hair. Chung Chung might not seem an ideal solution to the problem, but he's not expected to perform in the same way as the other males. With the female panda's biological clocks ticking away, Chung Chung has a more indirect but vital role to play. His semen has just been collected in the hospital, and while he recovers from the anaesthetic, his contribution to the breeding programme will be put to good use. As has happened many times before, Chung Chung has been a vital, if unwitting, participant in the plan to save the planet's precious pandas. Feifei, having been successfully mated with Lulu, will now undergo artificial insemination. Many of the breeding females at Wulong are artificially inseminated as well as being mated naturally.
自然交配以后，我们再让它做人工受精，这个双胞胎率要增加30%左右。
Twins have played a crucial part in reaching Wulong's breeding target and making it a success story. Before Feifei can undergo artificial insemination, she needs to be anaesthetised. She must be thoroughly checked over and, most importantly, weighed to ensure that the right amount of anaesthetic is administered. Once sedated, she's raced to the hospital, so that the artificial insemination can be completed before she wakes up. The calculations were apparently wrong. But for safety, they erred on the side of caution. Too little is better than too much. The artificial insemination is completed and Feifei is put in a quiet enclosure away from the breeding pens. They won't know for sure if it was successful until late summer, when the birthing season begins. Many of the other females in the block are also stimulated by the comings and goings in the other pens. Shishi starts chirping and moaning very loudly, and it's decided to try Wu Gong to see if she is more his type than Feifei. Shishi is visibly irritated by Wu Gong's apparent incompetence. She turns on him. Then Wu Gong suddenly reveals another side to his character. Perhaps he's not the apathetic, passive panda he appears to be. Despite his outburst, the keepers know Wu Gong's true character and easily tempt him away from Shishi with his real interest in life. Lulu, meanwhile, is being reacquainted with his very first love, Ying Ying. Like Lulu, she was a wild caught panda, but at 8 years older, more mature and experienced. But Lulu's lost that loving feeling and shows absolutely no interest. Disappointed, they move her through to Wu Gong. But no joy. Aware that Ying Ying's hormone level has peaked and is dropping, there's a sense of urgency. But persisting with Lulu backfires horribly. It may look frightening, but the keepers aren't worried. The centre's director is also unperturbed by the violence and points to an even more logical explanation for the aggression. As is painfully evident when Lulu is introduced to Long Shin. Perhaps best illustrated when Ling Ling is introduced to Mei Cheng, and the situation becomes even more violent. She races next door to try to get away from him. Once safely indoors, Mei Cheng is clearly terrified, but only suffers minor cuts and scratches. Nothing serious.
We've been in the wild for so many years, we haven't found a 把熊猫给打到死亡的是没有的。
Comparing the behavior of captive pandas and their wild relatives is an important part of Wulong's work. The long-term plan is to release some of Wulong's pandas into the wild. One of the reasons there are only 8 breeding pens available out of a possible 10 is because 2 of the pens are currently being used by the release team. As more and more females start to come into estrus, the breeding team thinks they should have priority over the pens. Once they've successfully reached the target of 300 pandas for a sustainable captive population, the hope is to use those pandas to help reach a sustainable wild population of 3,000. But the centre's director is sceptical.
I think 大熊猫这个野生大熊猫要摆脱濒危，并不是说我们野生大熊猫要我们圈养大熊猫要繁殖多少野生大熊猫才摆脱濒危。它不可能说无限制的增加，因为每个大熊猫它活动的范围从3平方公里到15平方公里，它有一个活动范围的，在这么个大范围内，不可能说你从一只熊猫跟它增加的很大，所以在野生大熊猫这个种群数量方面，你要快速的增加是不可能的。所以说我只能说，我们人工繁殖的情况下，尽最大努力来满足这个圈养大熊猫一个可持续发展。所以说，你总体数量能，全国的那个野生大熊猫总体数量呢要达到3000只，这只是我们希望它达到。
The real problem for wild pandas remains the lack of protected habitat.This is part of that precious protected habitat. 850 kilometers northeast of Wulong, 6,000 feet up in the Qinling Mountains. On the site of an ancient Buddhist temple, a team of scientists at the Qinling Giant Panda Research Base have been studying the behavior of wild pandas for more than a decade.The damp climate may be good for bamboo and pandas, but it's not so good for humans trying to study them. When there is a break in the clouds, observing the behavior of wild pandas is considered easier here than in Sichuan.
到这边来了，看见大熊猫的频率呢，那个频率还是比较高的。相对四川那边来说，四川在野外要看见一只大熊猫非常困难。在这里呢，它那个地，一个是地形非常平坦，另外一个。